Malikum. Grüße, hello, or whatever you call it. It has to be real. This is Stefan Häger. I'm talking to you from Switzerland, and I show you about originality of bread panini. It has to be what it says. It has to be real bread. Or if it's Walser water, the Swiss water, it has to be exactly what it says. Look at this. Whether this is a self-service here, a coffee shop, this is bread, real Swiss bread, and it has to be real, or it has to be this coffee. It's black coffee with some cream in it. It has to be real. And if we look today at what God says through Jesus in the Bible, I've got here this little Bible in English. It's a Gideon's Bible, and it says that it would be something, a New Testament, the Psalms, the Injil. It deals with everyday experience of life. It gives advice and help and instructions, warning, comfort and hope, correction, direction, perception, and of course promises. God promises something, and it is yes and amen. It's for you and it's for me. Let's see what Jesus says in the Sermon of the Mount when he deals with everyday life situations. We look at Matthew chapter 5, the Injil, Mattiki Injil. Matthew chapter 5 deals and 6 and 7 deals with life issues, ethical life issues, moral issues, how to behave towards one another, and how to behave towards God. Look at this. Oaths. Jesus says here, you have heard, it was said, you and the people long ago, do not break your oath. Okay? But keep the oaths you have made to the Lord. But I tell you, Jesus says, do not swear at all, either by heaven, for it is God's throne, or by the earth, for it is his footstool, or by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. And do not swear by your head, for you cannot make even one hair white or black. Simply let your yes be yes, and your no, no. Anything beyond this comes from the evil one. So as I'm sitting here at this railway station in Switzerland, we have to be authentic, just like the Swiss tend to be authentic. Whatever is on our heart should be on our lips. That's what it says here in this text. Jesus wants to say, don't say, oh, I swear, or I swear by this Bible, or I do this and that. No, just whatever is in your heart, when you speak it, it should be true and truthful. And why is this? Look at this. Something which the Swiss built in the past. They laid a good and strong foundation, and it lasts for the next generation. Whatever they put material in this building, it stands for a long time, for centuries at times. This is because they did not cheat. There was no corruption. Look at this coffee shop. The prices he offers here are what we pay for, and we drink exactly what we pay for. There is no deception. God doesn't like deception. Jesus says, therefore, don't swear by Jerusalem or something, or by your own head. You cannot even count your hair, and you cannot even make the blonde hair gray or black or what. We can put color on, but it's not real. It's not authentic. So you and me, we know this. We should be authentic. This place, which is called Thun, this railway station, where the trains come, they go from Bern to the overland into the mountains in the Alps. We have to be authentic. This place, Thun, could be the Jerusalem because there are many believers and followers of Jesus Christ in this place. So in Switzerland, people call this place the Jerusalem of Switzerland, would you believe? But we should not hide behind such a place and say, by this place, I'm coming from this place, so I'm authentic, I don't tell lies. I speak the truth. But we should, just as we think in our heart, should be on our lips. We should speak it. So Jesus, when he says yes, should be yes, and no, should be no. We should follow him because he is the life-giving word.